Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, we are going to look at how you can manage or govern personal gateways in your organization. Let's do this. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, personal gateways. A lot of enterprise organizations don't necessarily want just open-ended personal gateways that people can just go install and do all this stuff. This actually came up in a customer conversation I was having last week. So shout out to Mark Cooper, who was asking, how do we block personal gateways for our organization? So let me go ahead and actually show you how this works. Before we get into that though, I need to add some caveats or just some understandings of what you're going to need to actually get this going. The data gateway PowerShell commandlets are going to require the PowerShell core installed. So make sure you have that. So as I step through these commands, I'll have links in the description below to those actual commands that you can go reference. All right, enough of all this talking. You know, we like to do it here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. So we're going to start our journey out on the Power Platform Admin Center. If you are a global admin or a Power BI service admin for your tenant, also if you're a Power Platform admin, you can get here as well. You'll want to go to the actual data preview area. This is where you can see the gateways that are installed in your organization. Remember that an on-premise data gateway can actually be used in more spots than just Power BI. The personal gateway is just for Power BI though. So if we're looking here, we can see we've got our on-premises data gateways. These are the enterprise gateways. I can come up here and switch to personal mode. So these are the personal gateways that are installed in my organization. One thing I want to call out here is this manage gateway installers. So this allows you through the UI to block installation or manage installation of the on-premises data gateway from an enterprise mode perspective. This does not control the personal gateway. The only way to control the personal gateway is through PowerShell. So if I come over to PowerShell, this is using the data gateway PowerShell commandlet. Again, links down in the description below. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to connect to the gateway service. And I've got to go ahead and select my credential. We're connected. There's two main PowerShell commandlets. There is get data gateway tenant policy and then set data gateway tenant policy. So there's always a get and a set. Data gateway tenant policy is the main one. So this blocks for the whole organization. And then there's another one called data gateway installer, which actually lets you to allow individuals or groups to be able to do the installing. So if we do get data gateway tenant policy, we can see that there's no policy here for my tenant. I'm going to block installation of the on-premises data gateway, the enterprise mode of it. And you'll see there's Adam and Patrick already listed here. We do trust Patrick. Just know that. So now that this is enabled, let's go run that command again and see what we get. And now you can see enterprise install restricted. Through the UI, we controlled the enterprise gateway. And we've now said that that is a restricted policy, meaning you have to be in the whitelist or the allowed list to be able to install. And we can use the get data gateway installer command to see who can install what. These are the Azure AD object IDs. So this could either be for a group or for a user. We'll see here that the resource type is the enterprise gateway. And then there's a personal type, which is the personal gateway. Patrick only is allowed to install the on-premises data gateway enterprise mode. And my account is allowed to install both. Between these two command areas, so the get and sets for the policy and the installer, we can actually control and manage who can actually install the gateways in our organization. So I want to block personal gateway installation. So I'm going to use the set data gateway tenant policy to do this. I'm actually going to set the personal gateway install policy to restricted. You can see above that only enterprise install restricted was set. So now I'm going to set the personal gateway install policy. That is set. Let's take a look again at our tenant policies to make sure that it's in place. And now we can see personal install restricted and enterprise install restricted. What does this actually do? So now what we've said is that by default, nobody can install either the enterprise gateway or the personal gateway, unless I've actually explicitly said they can do it. But this does not stop any existing installation. So if people already had the personal gateway installed, you got to go clean that up or manage that outside of this process. Or you can go and see who all has a personal gateway and you can remove those. Here, let me show you. So if we go back to the admin center, remember we are looking at the personal modes and we can see that both myself and Patrick have one installed. I'm going to remove the gateway for myself. And now that is gone. Let's verify that. So I've installed the personal gateway and I want to get this installed from my John Doe account. Let's go and sign in. And we've got to put in our password. And when we go to sign in, we will then get a message saying, nope, you've been blocked by your organization. So please contact your service admin or your tenant admin. So our policy is in place and it is working. Bam. that's what we wanted. But from an admin perspective, I know John and he's all right and he's got a valid business case for what he needs to use a personal gateway. So I want to allow John to actually install the gateway. So that's where we can set the data gateway installer just for John. Let's see what that looks like. What I love about PowerShell is all of this can be scripted and you can add this to existing processes that you may have from an automation standpoint. What I'm going to do is I'm going to call the set data gateway installer. I'm going to say principal object IDs. This is John Doe's object ID from Azure AD. You can either get this through the portal. There's also Azure AD PowerShell commandlets where you can go get this from. So that can all be automated. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to say add John Doe to the personal gateway type. So you could also call remove if you wanted to remove them from the allowed list. So before the 6A2 ID is not in the list. Let's go ahead and add it. Let's verify that 62A is in the list and I do see it. So that is good. Now let's try and go and install the gateway again. Sign in. Bam. My personal gateway is now installed. If we come back and we refresh the list, we can now see that John Doe's personal gateway is listed and installed. So we're able to actually control the actual installation from a tenant perspective, and we can allow individuals or groups to be allowed to install either the personal gateway or the enterprise gateway. And remember that this does not stop existing installs. So you have to manage that separately. This just prevents new installs of the personal gateway. All right, I want to hand this over to you. Does this help you with governing your organization from a personal gateway perspective? Let me know down in the comments below what you think and if this kind of opened your eyes to some things you can do with the gateways. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button, smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.